No problem.
Hi guys, this is your Doc JP again, SkyMedic, and we will be streaming again this flight from Mactan, Cebu, going to Cotabato using this Airbus A319, and we will be using a real-world flight call signs Philippine 2223, however, that is a dash 8, gagamitin na natin is Airbus 319. Magandang umaga, guys, time check, it's ready 10:55 in the morning and the 20th. Day of December 2022, and it's a Tuesday morning here in the Philippines. Welcome to the stream. As you can see, we'll be in command of this Airbus A319, and we're currently parked here at the old passenger terminal of Mactan Cebu International Airport. And according to our fly overlay on the top of the screen, we will be going to Cotabato, that is Romeo Papa Mike Charlie. We'll be covering around 189 nautical miles of routes from Mactan to Cotabato, Awang Airport, and this will just take us around 41 minutes of flight time for cruising altitude of 23,000 feet. Alright, so welcome, and let's now start our flight. Let's review our flight plan. Spotify batay. Alright, so this is our flight plan. So, basahin muna natin. Alright, so this is a Mactan Cebu going to Awang Airport in Cotabato. Cost index natin will be 23 and our cruising altitude is 23,000 feet. So, total destination natin is approximately 190 or 189 nautical miles. Total block fuel natin for this flight is 5 tons, rounded off na natin to 5. And our expected departure will be runway 04 via the Cobol to Alpha departure. And our route will be Cobol Whiskey towards Seekin. So after Seekin, that will be a visual approach for runway 28 in Cotabato. Okay, we will have no star for our arrival. Total passengers natin is 103. Cargo natin, total of 1 ton. Yung freight dyan is 300 kilograms. Zero fuel weight natin is 51.4. And as I've said earlier, fuel natin is 5 tons. Takeoff weight natin is estimated 56.2 tons. And our maximum is 64.4. And minimum landing weight natin will be 54.3. Just below 62.5, which is our maximum landing weight. So wala tayo problema. Our fuel is good for our flight going to Cotabato and to our alternative airport, which is Davao International Airport, with an extra 45 minutes worth of fuel. Alright, so according to Batson, this is our flight, 23,000 feet. In route time is 41 minutes. Fuel endurance is good for 1 hour or almost 50 or almost 2 hours flight time. Alright, so that is our route for this morning. Let's go in our cockpit. Okay, some of the floors and procedures that are being used in this stream may not follow those in real world, so this is for pure entertainment and gaming purposes only, guys. Okay, so let's brighten up first our screens. At the same time, we will check our radios. Okay, 122.8. Bakit? Okay, 122.8. Bakit wala akong naririnig? Oh, wait. Check natin. Bakit hindi ko narinig? 122.8. Tama naman ah. Hmm.
check. Bakit kaya? Anyway, doon lang tayo mag-advise sa text mamaya. Pero it's working naman kapag gamit ko yung Airbus 319 at 321 pala sa X-Plane 12. By the way, we are using X-Plane 11 muna guys since wala po tayong 319. Initial plan with 15,000.
Okay, great. We're almost done. We'll let you know as soon as possible as everyone's on board. It shouldn't take much longer.
Okay, RPVM going to RPMC. Right natin is Philippine 223. 2223 rather. Cost index will be 23. Cruising altitude is 23,000 feet then. Okay, quick align na lang tayo. Hindi ka na makapaghintay para mabilis ang flight natin. Okay, ZFW, let's see, 51.4. Oops, sorry. 51.4, 28.7. Block fuel is 5 tons. Flight plan, COBOL. Then Whiskey 21, Airways. Sorry, Whiskey 21, then Seekin. Alright, so runway 04 po tayo. Ayun, naririnig ko na. Alright, runway 04, COBOL to Alpha departure. Okay, flaps 2 tayo. Pwede na tayo mag-flaps 1 kasi mahaba na yung runway dito eh. So, flaps 1 tayo for departure, up 0.2%. Flex temperature natin will be 65. V1 and VR is 130 and our V2 is 132. Okay. Ayan. Okay, check natin yung route natin according sa ating nilagay na flight plan. Okay, so diretso yan, intercept to big COBOL, Forta, Seekin, tapos after that runway 28 daw eh. Siyempre walang star yan. Okay. Diretso lang tayo sa center fix mamaya. Mag-radar vectors tayo mamaya. Alright. So walang problema doon. Balik natin sa ARC 20. Okay. Right now we are using Active Sky XP since gumagana ito sa X-Plane 11. So, visibility is more than 10 kilometers. No precipitation. QNH is 1008. Temperature natin is 28. And winds natin wind calm. Alright, 1008. Okay, checking our instruments. Alright, everything is working. Let's set na squawk natin for 100, mode Charlie. May kasama tayo dito, nagre-radio check kanina, nasaan ba yan? Ayun, si Cool Red 215, sino kaya to? Cool Red 215, bro, wala pa siyang flight plan. Alright. Next thing gonna do is gonna open our charts for Mactan Cebu in preparation for our departure. Delayed na tayo ng konti sa flight natin, guys. Expedite na natin. Close the doors na natin. Okay, let's now have our departure briefing muna. We are using Jeppesen Charts 10-9, published 13th of December 2019. Airport elevation is 35 feet, and we are currently parked here at the old terminal, so we expected to depart runway 04, so gina commence push facing southwest.
Ground to cockpit. Please show me where you want to go.
Tell us driving up. We'll be up in the air in the next now the ground crew are loading the last bit of luggage onto the aircraft, so if you could please get yourself seated and secured in the meantime, we can make departure as soon as they're finished. Thank you. Cabin crew, go ahead and arm the doors. Thank you.
Alright, so again, let's continue our departure briefing. We are planning to taxi via Foxtrot Bravo, then Kilo, then hold short runway 04. Departure runway natin na sa Lecom 3.3 kilometers. For our SID, this will be 10-3 Foxtrot. Published 24th of December 2021. Effectivity is 30th of December. Cobalt 2 Alpha departure. Airport elevation 35 feet. Transition altitude 11,000 feet. So Cobalt 2 Alpha runway 04.
Ready to connect.
Alright, just a straight out departure to 2000 feet and turn right climbing turn. Then our routing will be intercept and track out Mactan Radial 176 Trocos Tubig at above 5000 feet. Continue climb to cross Cobol at above 6000. Okay, 2000, liliko lang tayo to the right, intercept Radial 176 ng Mactan towards Tubig at above 5000 feet, then at Cobol at above 6000 feet. Alright. Simple as that. Okay, let's now start our APU.
Tow connected and bypass pin inserted. Release parking brake.
Alright.
Okay, while waiting for our APU to be available, short recap of our flight. This is Philippine 2223, Airbus A319, departing Mactan Cebu International Airport. And we are inbound Cotabato Awang Airport, covering around 189 nautical miles. We have 103 passengers on board. Cargo natin is 300. Flight level will be 23,000 feet. And expected airtime is just 45 minutes. Okay, APU is now available. APU bleed on. Let's now remove our external power and let's start our flight. Okay, let's check. Alright, cabin doors are armed already and we're ready to go. Let's now have our before start checklist. Before start, cover pins completed, gear pins and covers removed, signs on auto, others on up, fuel quantity 5 tons check, takeoff data set. Initial climb will be 15,000 feet. Bar reference 1008 down to the line. Windows and doors are closed. Beacon lights on. Thrust levels on idle. Parking brakes are required before start checklist is complete. Mactan traffic, Philippine 2223. Commencing push and start for runway 04. Nandito pa yung kasama ko. Alright. Push na siya. Alright. Engine mode selector to ignite. Number crosses. Be pressure up. Parking brakes release.
Starting pushback, and you may start engine.
Up lux time set. Starting engine number one. Okay, we will be doing a one engine taxi na lang, guys.
Before we depart, we want to let you know how much we care about your safety. This is inspired by everyone in the country for the safety of everyone.
Flaps 2. And spoilers on.
P Be sure all carry-on items are securely stowed in the overhead compartment and small heavy items under the seat in front of you. That is also ensured that all aisles and exit rows are clear of any items.
Smoking in the airplane is strictly prohibited. This includes the use or charging of e-cigarettes.
Diyan pwede.
Also, tampering with, disabling, or destroying lavatory smoke detectors is a serious offense. Please set your mobile and tablet devices.
Okay, after start engine number 1 checklist, APU bleed off.
Make sure to store
your traffic clear, 215 taxiing 045 Bravo.
Okay, APU bleed off.
Operation complete. Go ahead and set the parking brake.
Parking brake set.
Please call a cabin crew member for
disconnecting tow. Stand by.
Okay, cross bleed. Yellow electric pump on.
Fasten your seatbelt throughout the flight, especially during
set nothing pitch trim, nothing to up.
Insert the metal end into the buckle until you hear a click. To tighten, pull the loose end of the strap.
Up 0.2%.
Reach your seatbelt, lift the top of the buckle,
there you go.
And pull the
trim to set to zero.
Please fasten your seatbelt over your blanket so our crew can easily see that you're safely strapped in.
Hand signals are expected on my right side.
Should there be a rapid change in cabin pressure, oxygen masks will automatically drop in front of you. When this happens, pull mask firmly towards you to start the flow of oxygen. Place it over your nose and mouth, pull the elastic band for a snug fit and breathe normally.
So is disconnected and bypass pin has been removed. Hand signal on the right. We'll see you next time and have a safe flight.
Remember to put on your own mask first before assisting others. Keep mask on until you're advised to remove it.
Emergency exits are clearly marked along each side of the cabin. Please locate the nearest exit, which may be behind you. Map markings will guide you to the emergency exit.
Alright, hand signals received on my right. After start, engine number 1 checklist is complete.
Remove all sharp
alright, let's do
off
flight controls check on the rudders. Full left.
Wait for instructions.
Full right, neutral, elevators, pull up. Pull down, neutral, ailerons, pull left, pull right, neutral, alright.
In case of a water landing, your life vest can be found under your seat or inside your center console.
Makan traffic.
To use your life vest,
Philippine 2223, commencing taxi, Foxtrot, Bravo, Kilo, for runway 04.
Wrap your belt around your waist and push the end to buckle. Inflate your life vest by pulling down
the inflation
cords
will be on my
at
side.
The bottom,
parking brakes release, pressure zero.
To release air, brake check. Push pin inwards.
Working.
Alright, the life vest only outside the aircraft. Your life vest light will automatically switch on once submerged in water.
We've covered almost everything, but before takeoff and landing, please have your seatbelt securely fastened, your footrest, tray table, and in-seat monitor stowed, window shade raised, and your seat in an upright position. Pagkatapos, salamat.
Now that we're all settled, you can learn more about our in-flight safety procedure from reading the safety card found in the seat pocket in front of you.
Okay, clear on the right side, clear
also,
on the left side.
Please be extra careful when handling hot beverages.
Ladies and gentlemen, sit back and relax as we're about to take off. We hope you enjoyed this in-flight safety video made by the Filipino, for the Filipino, and for the world.
Mabuhay! From Philippine Airlines, the heart of the Filipino.
Okay, clear on the left side, clear on the right side.
Taking off runway 04 para for Papa.
Okay, short update ng flight natin. This is Philippine 2223 rather, Airbus 319. Currently about to depart Mactan Cebu International Airport. We are currently taxiing on Bravo towards runway 04. And we will be heading to Awang Airport in Cotabato. This will be around approximately 45 minutes flight time, covering 189 nautical miles, carrying 103 passengers, and our cruising altitude will be 23,000 feet. Currently, we are doing a one-engine taxi towards runway 04. Benedict Garcia, ano gamit mo sa announcement? Ang ganda. It's part of, actually, dinownload ko po yun sa YouTube ng Philippine Airlines, then converted to MP3, then I loaded it on my self-loading cargo plug-in. Ayan, yung nakikita niyo sa right side ng screen natin, this is the self-loading cargo. So, nandoon yung mga PAs natin. Alright. Prepare na tayo for our engine number to start up. So, checklist natin, yellow electric pump off and APU bleed is on. Okay. Starting engine number 2. Yata, self-loading cargo yata is very weird to serve. As far as I could remember. Ito yung nakikita niyo sa right side. So, ito yung interface niya, voices, features, sound effects, penalties, third party. Pati nga yung mga landing rates nandito din eh. Tapos, mga PA announcements, kung kailan mag-seatbelt signs off, kailan iikot yung ating mga cabin crew, in case of emergency. Meron din dito simulation of ang tawag nga doon dito, passenger manifest. Ayan, nakikita niya natin. Merong random passengers dito na nakalagay, mga pangalan nito, ano yung feeling nila, ano yung gutom, sino natutulog, merong ganyan. Ayan. Ito yung cockpit natin, Airbus 319. Nakikita natin, nakaupo na yung mga pasahero natin. Ito yung distribution. Actually, mga pasahero natin umiikot pa sa hallway. Ah, pasahero. Cabin crew natin. Open nga natin.
Cabin crew, go ahead and take your seat.
Parang the same siya ng PAC-X, sir. Okay, after that, start engine number 2 checklist. APU bleed is now being turned off. Cross bleed is APU is back to auto. Anti-ISS record ECAM status check. After start engine number 2 checklist, let's do the before takeoff checklist. Flight controls check, flight instruments check, briefing confirmed. Flap setting configured 2B1 VRV. Flex temperature 130 blue, 132 magenta. Flex temperature natin is 65. ATC set natin to 4100 squawking mode. Charlie, ikaw memo take off no blue down to the line. Okay, cabin crew is now seated and cabin is secured. Ready for departure. Mactan traffic, Philippine 2223 approaching Kilo for holding point runway 04. Any aircraft on base and final, please advise. Okay, below the line na tayo. Take off runway 04. Confirm cabin crew advice. TCAS on TARA. Engine mode selector to norm. And PAX will be off for this departure. Landing lights on. PAX off. Kamusta yung dinner kahapon, Doc? Masarap. Kaso nga lang, ang lamig. Okay, clear right side, clear left side. Mactan traffic, Philippine 2223, lining up runway 04 via Kilo. Konting dinner lang, tapos nag-ikot-ikot sa plaza. Tapos no, naka-uwi ng 9 o'clock. Tapos yun, nag-ATC pa tayo kagabi, I think. Yan, nag-ATC pa tayo sa Mactan for around 1 hour and a half. Tapos online yung ating Manila controller. at the same time yung approach controller sa Manila and tower controller. Okay, clear on the arriving side. Clear on the departing side. Checking on VATSIM. Alright, walang problema. Let's go. Slides to take off na tayo. Ready to roll. Makan Traffic, Philippine 2223, rolling runway 04. Okay. Napas po na natin ito. Power 50%. Engine stable. Manflex 65 SRS. Auto thrust blue check. Corona time on. Thrust set. 100 knots.
100.
V1 rotate. Pacific flight, gear up.
Positive flight, gear up.
Okay, autopilot one engage. Thrust flight check. Flaps 1, speed check flaps 1. Mactan traffic, Philippine 2223, airborne passing 2,700 feet on Cobalt to Alpha departure, IFR. Cotabato. Flap 0, speed check flap 0. Okay, no need for okay, passing wind dot, gun spoilers disarm, no slides off, back one on. Back to on.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to start in 5 minutes. Like to watch, please plug in your headphones and select channel 3 from your arm left to left. Thank you and enjoy the film.
Okay, wala tayong traffic. Let's fly direct Cobol. Traffic advisory, Philippine 2223. Directing Cobol, climbing 230. Okay, climb na tayo 230. After takeoff climb checklist, landing gear up, flaps retracted, backs are on, down to the line. Alright, 10,000 feet, landing lights off, the turbulences, seatbelt signs off. 11,000 feet, passing transition altitude standard set, passing flight level 113. Now, the difference down to the line after takeoff man checklist is now complete. Let's do our flow, steering and they will be off on my side. Let's increase our navigation display to 80 nautical miles lang. Okay, checking our rad nav. Wala naman tayo clear dito. Progress page na natin, lagay na natin RPMC runway 28. Okay, report natin. We are already 97 nautical miles from our top of descent. Expected to be commencing our descent to Cotabato at around 40 minutes past the hour 11, or that will be around 15 minutes from now. Prepare na natin
yung turn. Clear back to the food. Please make sure the tray table is in the down position and clear
the aisle. Wala naman pala tayong chart sa RPMC. Joke. Wala tayong chart. Hi Jared, kumusta yung flight mo papuntang Hilo International Airport sa Hawaii? Hawaii ba? Yeah, papuntang Hawaii si Jared. Long haul flight ah. Watching for the CR. Yung piloto nasa CR tapos lumilipad siya nasa Pacific Ocean siya papuntang Hawaii. Yes, Sir Benedict, nag-online kagabi. Nag-online ako tapos I think meron pa akong traffic around 10. Tapos ang busy ng Philippines kahapon for a Monday evening. Marami talagang gustong mulipad on VATSIM sa Pilipinas. Bumabawi kahapon kasi diba, in the past weeks and months, meron ng pasok, medyo matumala yung lumilipad during weekdays. Pero kahapon, it's a Monday evening. Tapos meron tower, dalawang tower, Mactan and Manila. May approach sa Manila. Then, si Sir Emilio nag-online as our controller in the Philippines. Tapos daming lumilipad. Grabe, parang hindi Lunes kahapon. Maraming salamat talaga, guys. Okay, let's start hot drinks. Yes, exactly, sir. Holiday na kasi. Alright, so wala tayong charts. Open na natin. Expander natin. Meeple. Then, settings. Meron tayo akong paborito dito. Baka may nagsuggest kayo kaninong magandang file. Kasi meron dito sa A300 ako pinatandaan. Ito lang yung paborito ko so far. Okay, we are using real world weather, time and date. So, yung flight natin ngayon is December 20 at 11:28. And siguro babalik tayo sa cockpit natin mamaya around 11:35 in preparation for our arrival. Yeah. Yes, paano yan, Doc? If walang charts, visual approach lang. Yes, exactly, sir. Yung mangyayari mamaya, i-detector ko lang muna yung sarili ko hanggang center fix ng runway 28 ng Cotabato, then visual approach yan. Kaya kapag gusto niyo pumunta ng Cotabato, yung sasabihin ng ATC controller, sandali lang. Yan. So yung mayayari, bibigyan namin kayo ng clear. You're cleared to Cotabato IFR until seeking. Yan.
Yan yung sinasabi namin. Cotabato, ano pa ba? Dipolog,
Naga, usually mga principal airports yan, Siargao, mga ganyan. Tapos kapag kunyari may Manila controller na online, pagdating niya ng Seekin, sasabihin niya shift to Unicom kasi hindi niya na-control kayo, kasi hindi na siya IFR. Hanggang Seekin lang yan. So mangyayari, kunyari, kapag may meron tayong Manila controller ngayon, pagdating ko ng Seekin, papadesign niya tayo papuntang Cotabato visual approach na, then sasabihin niya shift to Unicom na, even though meron tayong controller. Same math 32 videos watching from flight level 39,000 on my way to VCBI. Alright, what flight number are you, sir? Going to VCBI. Saan ba yung VCBI? O, diba? Napag-google tayo ng konti dito. Okay. Hanapin na lang natin dito. Ayun. The only inbound for VCBI. Ayan, so nag-comment sa YouTube natin si Matt32Videos. He is MCA123737 from Karachi. Inbound. Anong airport ba to? Bandara Nike. Oo nga, nakapag-land na tayo dito. Saan ba to? Sri Lanka. Ah, alright. Sa may Colombo. May Colombo yata to, diba? Ayan, oh. Ito siya. Hi, Sir Matt. Nice to see you here. MCA123, welcome aboard sa stream. So ito siya, guys. MCA123, and tayo naman na dito, Philippine 2223. Alright. Yeah, Osamis din. Walang IFR. So visual din. Niinggit ako talaga, Dox Explain, camera view sa MSFS, walang kanyan, yung nilalagay ang cam sa fixed position, ganda pa ng cinematics. Actually, sa X-Pi, this is for X camera, yung payware na plug-in. Pero, for me kasi, because of yung latest release kasi ng X-Plane 12, parang ang toxic ng Facebook page ngayon ng X-Plane 12 kasi marami nagre-reklamo ng mga users na kumuha ng X-Plane 12, mas maganda daw si MSFS. O ako kasi, it depends kasi kung ano yung preferred mo na ako. Kung gusto mo realism or more of graphics ka. Kasi mas maganda talaga ang graphics ni Microsoft Flight Simulator, no problem. No art about that. And for the physics naman ng aeroplano, since hindi naman tayo real-world pilot, we're just basing it to the reactions or the comments ng mga real-world pilots natin. Like, for example, dito sa Pilipinas, si Sir Captain JC Rage, Sir David ng Sputnik Aviation. So doon ako nagbe-base na lang ng mga reactions nila kung saan talaga mas maganda. So I think it's not a competition between MSFS and X-Plane or Flipart 3D or ano pa ba, ano pang iban ang kapong simulator ba. Basta importante dyan, we are all connected sa Batsim at nag-enjoy tayo, diba? Okay, time check is 11:32. In 3 minutes time, gonna go back sa ating cockpit. Saan tayo magandang lumipad mamayang hapon? If I'm using my Airbus 319, I'm using my X-Plane L12. But for my Airbus A319, since this is a short flight, tapos short din yung runway ng Cotabato, so I'm using A319. Parang gusto ko nga mag-Baguio uli eh. Tapos sa kabilang runway naman tayo maglalanding. Yo, Rorich, kung nanonood ka, maybe di muna, sir. Medyo may problema tayo ngayon sa GCash natin. Okay, since wala tayong chart, open na lang tayo ng Wikipedia kung ano yung airport sa Cotabato. Okay, Awang Airport, ICAO code RPMC, runway length natin is, wala ba dito? Ayan, 1.9 kilometers. So, So, ang ikli lang. So, kaya pinili ko ang Airbus 319. Wala naman tayong Dash 8. Meron tayong Q4, pero pinapraktisan pa natin paano ilipad. Medyo complicated si Q4 eh. Alright, so, airport serving the general area of Cotabato City, North Cotabato and Maguindanao del Norte and Maguindanao del Sur, located in the province of Maguindanao del Norte in the Philippines, and is classified as a Class 1 principal or major domestic airport by the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines. Okay, the airport is the 21st busiest airport in the Philippines in 2021, and the airport is generally used for the people of Cotabato. Alright, so 1.9 kilometers yung landay na natin. Ang importante, Doc, yung landing rate ko ma-lower down from constant 500. More practice lang yan, sir. I think kaya. Meron namang lumilipad ng MSFS talaga na kaya nila mag-butter o maganda ng landing. Okay, how do you get the METAR from airport na walang METAR talaga? Like RPSP, pangal should use RPPM since malapit lang. Yes. Like for example, dito sa amin sa Western Visayas, usually walang METAR yung Iloilo, Katikulan, and Rojas, Calipo. You usually use the METAR on the nearest big airport or mayroong available na METAR, which is Mactan, Cebu. However, yung Katikulan is halfway between Mactan and Manila, so you could use both. Pero dito sa flight natin, we are using ActiveSky XP. Ayan, yung ginagamit din ni Sir Eric Trinidad. So, ito yung ating Active XP and meron siyang latest weather information. So, we're expecting light rain mamaya sa Cotabato. Visibility is more than 10 kilometers. And QNH is 1006, ground temperature is 25, but wind calm 336 at 2 degrees and runway 28 tayo for our arrival. Okay, balik tayo sa cockpit muna tayo guys. Naka-heading direkto na tayo. Okay, let's descend to 15,000 feet na. Traffic advisory Philippine 2223, leaving flight level 230, descending 15,000 feet, expecting visual approach, runway 28, Cotabato. Pwede ka mag-spawn as ATIS, Doc, no? Kapag, kasi S2 lang ako, tower controller yung certified na pinakamataas ko makontrol, pwede na ako mag-provide ng ATIS sa airport or sa aerodrome kung saan ako nagko-control. Even though we have already the capability like the bat ATIS ngayon, pwede magbigay ng at the most 4 ATISs sa cover nila, pero pwede lang yun sa approach or sa radar controllers natin. Basically, yung approach and the main controller or the Manila controller. Pero kapag tower ka, kung saan lang yung aerodrome kang pwede. Ginawa yon ng VAT 80s na multiple 80s kasi pwede din sa tower. Like for example, other airports, dalawa yung 80s nila. The departure 80s and the arrival 80s. Pwede ganyan. Pero different airports, di pwede, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, we think we're heading to our destination. We're not expecting any major delays or anything like that at this time. And expect you on the ground here in about 20 minutes or so. The cabin crew by handing them any trash or anything, that'd be much appreciated. For safety reasons, please turn off all electronic devices and switch them to airplane mode until we've landed. Please also be seated until we come to the gate. Thank you.
Hindi pa tapos mag-serve ng pagkain yung mga crew ko. Ayan, ano mga sino kaya? Sino satisfied dito? Ayan, sino anxious? Wala akong count. Sino si Williams Rose? Rose Williams, 75 years old. Satisfaction, anxious, healthy. Bored, hindi naman siya bored. Okay, sino kaya mga bored dito? Wala? Alright, walang bored dito. walang natutulog, lahat 14 passengers nanonood. Grabe, may drunk pa talaga. Sinong nasa CR, meron ganun. Pili tayo ng pasahero dito. Okay, cabin crew natin, si Denise Garrett, 25 years old, monitoring passengers. Okay, si Steve, 47 years old. Alright, pili tayo ng pasahero dito. Satisfaction, okay, ganda. Alright, walang problema. Treat talaga? Wait. Parang hindi pwede eh. Kasi 80s lang talaga hindi tower yung pi... No, meron tower yung kwan, yung Honolulu. Ayan, no? Meron tower, oh. Hindi siya pwede mag-activate ng 80s kapag hindi siya connected ng Euroscoop. Kasi maghahanap niya ng CID-ID yung VAT 80s or whatever 80s plug-in yung ginagamit namin. Meron siyang tower, oh. Jared. Okay, hindi pa sila tapos mag-serve ng pagkain. Short flight lang kaya. 45 minutes of flight time, tapos magsiserve ka ng 103 passengers ng pagkain. Okay, descend further to 10,000 feet. Okay, transition altitude or transition level pala natin is 13,000 feet. Okay, set na natin yung perf pitch. Okay, QNH in Cotabato, 1006. Ground temperature, 25. Winds natin, 336 at 2 knots. Okay, wala tayong DA or MDA. Merong ganyan nangyayari pa minsan-minsan, Jared. Minsan magkakaproblema si tawag ba doon? Si Batspy. Nangyari na yan noon eh, dito sa Manila. Online yung approach, online yung Manila controller, pero hindi nagre-reflect sa Batspy, yung nagre-reflect lang talaga 80s. Pero yes, hindi ka makakapag-activate ng 80s hanggang hindi ka online na controller. Pati delivery controller pwedeng maglagay ng 80s. Alright, seatbelt signs na tayo. Okay, approach checklist, briefing confirmed, ECAM status check, seatbelt signs on, wala tayong minimums. Down to the line, bar reference will be set to 1006. Okay, 1006, check. Terrain ND will be actually 10,000 feet pa pala. Hindi ko makita yung center fix. Ayun, center fix. Mag-vector lang tayo mamaya. Nautical miles na lang, descend na ako, Brisbane. Ang layo ng lipad ni Rorich. Pero Rorich, pag nanonood ka, yung request mo, hindi pa talaga muna Rorich for the meantime kasi meron pa tayong problema sa Gcash link natin. Dipolog ka naman next time, Doc. Maghanap muna ako kasi na-delete yung sinirik ko sa Dipolog, guys. Kung sino may Dipolog, pahingi naman po. Na-delete yung Dipolog ko. Okay, landing lights on. Jared, baka meron ka. Pahingi naman. Okay, terrain and they will be on my side. Okay, alam ko may bundok dito eh. Okay, altitude natin sa center fix mamaya is 1,770. Okay, runway 28 po tayo magla-landing. Kaya nga ng Airbus 320, oh. Pwede naman pala A320. I think we descended early. Oo, nag-descend ako ng early. Kasi hindi ko nilagay yung center fix, direct sa center fix eh. Kulit nito. Ano kaya madidilip? Kif? Kif? Paano ba to? Kif Toyota? Hi sir, hello naman from Twitch. Hello sir. Yo, thanks for the follow sir Twitch. Magandang umaga. Okay, we are already on the 24th minute mark ng ating flight. Expected lang pala is 45 minutes. Kaya ba to? Mataas naman yung flight natin. Maintain muna tayo 10,000 feet dito. I think masyado akong early nag-descent. Avoid muna natin to. Okay, 160. Okay, wala tayong traffic in the vicinity. So, tayo na tayo na dito mag-vectors muna. Ayun, salamat Jared. Sige, sige. Try natin yan. Okay, descending 5,000. Bas natin to kasi nagre-rate self vector tayo ngayon. Okay, let's fly heading 190 left, right heading 190. If you don't mind, and if, this is for the self-loading cargo. Satisfaction meaning the satisfaction ng mga pasahero. Or satisfaction of my passengers. So, I'm gonna check here if they are satisfied or not with my flight. Because
yeah, for the cabin for landing.
For my airmanship, for my departure time, for my arrival time. So, this is the satisfaction part. So far, 83% are satisfied. We have 183 onboard passengers. All of them are seated and all of them are secured. So parang nape-pressure tayo dito kapag meron tayong ganito. Okay, heading 210. Okay, we're descending 5,000. Yeah, it's smooth, sir. Exactly. Okay, this is my passenger manifest. These are the names of all my 103 passengers, including my crew. They expect their baggages, their check-in baggages. Yeah, and they're enjoying the flight. They are relaxing. They're reading a book. They're reading a magazine. One of them is worried. The other one is talking. Right. Ay, I forgot. Okay, naka-landing lights na. Okay. All of them are seated already. As you can see here, before we start the flight, we will place here estimated off-blocks time and on-blocks time. So, yung plug-in na yung magkakalculate if ever we are already late for our departure, late for our arrival, the satisfaction of our passengers, it's all here. Then, our landing date we will just review later. Let's see. Alright, meron na tayong center fixed. Maaga tayong nag-descent. Okay, recap ng mitar natin for Cotabato. Our PMC will be expecting some showers on our arrival. However, with good visibility, more than 10 kilometers, QNH is 1006, ground temperature is 25, and wind is calm. Recap of our flight, this is Philippine 2223, Airbus A319, departed Mactan Cebu International Airport around 30 minutes ago, and we are already on our descent, continuing descent towards Cotabato Airport. We'll be expecting official approach runway 24, or correction, runway 28 rather. We have 103 passengers on board, and our cruising altitude earlier was 23,000 feet. Okay, we are just flying IFR until waypoint seek, and then after that, it's already all visuals for runway 28. Alright. Descent 3,000. Heading 190. Okay, checking our V app. Okay, V app natin is 130 lamang. So, napaka-slow. Hindi naman napaka-slow, pero slow yung V app natin. So, ibig sabihin, we'll give more flare mamaya para hindi tayo lumagapak sa runway ng Cotabato. Configuration natin will be flaps full. Alright. Ano pala yung airport elevation natin? I forgot. Airport elevation is 56 knot, and then 183 feet. Okay, so deploy tayo ng ating gears around siguro mga 2,700 feet above sea level. Credit card yung pang subscribe sa, hindi, one time payment lang siya, sir. Wala tayong center fix dito, na-delete na. Alright. Okay, mandatory altitude natin at center fix will be 1,700 feet. Okay, center fix is 137, nakikita natin dito. So, diyan na tayo mag-base mamaya sa center fix na. think masyadong mababa to. Early tayo nag-descend kanina. Left heading 120. Oh, interesting. What happened? Ano ba wala ng isla dito? Kasi this is within Mindanao eh. Right, toilets are locked, cabin secured, and crew seated. Alright, sandali lang. Namali pala tayo. Runway 28 tayo. Okay, sandali lang. Okay. Kaya pala. Let's fly 080 muna. Sa kabila pala tayo magla-landing. Mali. Alright. Climb muna tayo 3,000. My apologies. Yung mahirap po lang charts tayo, yung 28 pala dun sa kadila. Kaya pala parang mali-mali yung mga calculations ko kanina. And this is the first time I will land runway 28 pala. Alright, sige. Good style dito. Okay, downwind muna tayo pala for runway... Mali tayo ng calculations. 280 pala sa kabila. Okay, heading 100 tayo, then magra-right turn tayo, heading 190, then another 280 right turn towards runway 28. Eh, check natin, meron tayong visual ng runway. Yep, that's the runway. It's ayun ang airport natin. Cotabato Traffic Advisory, Philippine 2223, downwind runway 28. $2,000 din pala. Yes, Jared. Medyo pricey din. let's activate our... Okay, approach phase is now activated. Tama ba? Yep, it's already activated. Flaps 1, speed check, flaps 1. Flaps 2, speed check, flaps 2. Send 2,000. Extend muna tayo ng konting downwind for runway 28. Wala naman obstruction later. Okay, right heading 190. Spoilers arm. Lights on. Cotabato traffic, Philippine 2223, base, right base, runway 28.
2000.
Mandatory altitude 1,700. Pwede pa tayo mag-direct ng fix? Wala. Wala siyang direct fix. Wala pa visual of the runway eh. Wala tayong visual ng runway pa. Okay, right turn to 80. Okay, we have visual of the runway now. Mag-land sa runway 28 ah. Okay, 43 minutes na tayong airborne, 2 minutes to go or else delay tayo sa arrival. Okay. Disengage autopilot, my controls.
1,000.
Adjust natin muna. One white three reds. Nabutin natin yung light slope natin. Ayun. Right landing checklist, cabin crew advice, auto thrust on speed, auto brakes on medium, ikamemo landing blue, landing checklist complete. Hindi expect ng lakas ng hangin dito because siguro ng mountain. Okay, mag-flare tayo ng maayos dito. 130 ng VF natin. Cell spoilers. Reverse green. It's a bit too smooth. Loko to ah. 80 knots. Alright, 80 yung FBM natin. Nice. 40 knots, manual braking. It was a smooth landing. Nice. Oops, sobrang lakas ng sound nito. Flaps retracted, spoilers disarmed. Cotabato traffic, Philippine 223 landed. Okay, turning off our terrain MD, weather systems off na din, brake fans on, APMS start. I'm using a joystick, sir. Yeah, joystick. How do I turn that? Okay, 95% ng passengers natin satisfied sa landing natin. Alright, APU is now starting. Okay, landing checklist. After landing checklist, flaps retracted, spoilers disarmed, radar off, predictive winters off, down to the line, APU master switch on, and APU start. Okay, entering the ramp, turning off our lights, strobe lights off, clear left side, clear right side, shutting down engine number 2. Clear right side, clear left side. Alright, parking brake set. Pressure's up. Turning off. Okay, EP bleed on. And shutting down, enter number 1. Alright, N1 less than 10%. Beacon lights off and seatbelt signs off.
Cabin crew, disrupt doors please.
Alright, check na natin mamaya. Sandali lang. Thanks, sir. Thanks, sir. Nice landing then, alright. Alright, so expedite natin yung... Okay, let's view our flight report muna before we review our landing. Alright, so this is our flight report. Pilot grade A-. Bakit kaya? Landing rate natin is 80 feet per minute at 1.05G. A bit too smooth for our landing. I forgot pala, basa yung runway natin. It's a wet runway. Supposed to be wala tayo. Hindi tayo nag-landing rate ng ganito. Kasi mag-hydroplaning tayo. Anyways, passenger rating is 94.8%. So, there's an increase. There's a 26.5 improvement. Okay? The flight was great. Good communication. Your landing was very good, but while you ensured the comfort of your passengers, you're in danger of causing the aircraft to float down the runway, affecting stopping distance and potential control of the aircraft. Try to manage the flare a little bit better. Alright? Sige, tandaan natin yan. Manage natin mga... Overall, your passengers were happier after flying with you than they when they boarded. A job well done. Alright, scheduled departure, 03 Zulu's time. Of flux time natin, delayed for 8 minutes. However, scheduled arrival is 048 or 1208 in the afternoon. Of unblock natin is 0410. So, delayed lang tayo ng 2 minutes pero on time pa rin yan. Okay, wala tayong problema sa airmanship natin. All are green. Alright, so A- lang tayo dito. Okay, so let's close our self-loading cargo and let's now review our landing, disconnecting on VATSIM, and let's do the replay. Alright guys, welcome to Cotabato Awang Airport. Okay, let's review. Let's start with the right wing external view. Kumusta yung landing natin? Let's fast forward lang dito ng konti. Alright, 80 landing rate. Gusto ko yung malakas yung sound. Pagdagan natin yung konti. Ulitin natin, ulitin natin. Gusto ko yung talagang mukhagong talaga. Okay, let's now check left wing view, passenger view. Ano gusto niyo guys? Engine view or wing view? Ako kasi mas prefer ko yung wing view, pero sige, dalawa na lang gagawin natin. Kasi first time natin naglanding ng runway 28 eh. Ganito pala yung approach dito ng runway 28. Engine? Sige, let's do the engine after this. right, 79. Alright. Okay, another view. Let's check the engine view. There you go. Sige, last na lang guys. Let's check the tower view before we end the stream. Tanghalian na. Tower view. Okay, this is our tower view in Cotabato, Awang Airport. Alright. Muntik na tayo na kamali ng runway kanina. Runway 28 pala yung binigay sa atin ng Cinder. Okay, let's now have a short recap ng flight natin. That's just fast forwarded habang pabalik yung aeroplano natin to sa terminal. Alright. Short recap ng flight natin, we were live earlier on VATSIM as Philippine 2223, Airbus A319 of Toles. We are using X-Plane 211 and we just arrived here at Romeo Papa Mike Charlie, that is Awang Airport in Cotabato. And our total flight time was exactly 45 minutes, cruising altitude was 23,000 feet and we covered around 190 nautical miles of distance from our origin airport, which is Mactan Cebu International Airport in Central Visayas, Philippines. So we just did a short recap of our landing. So landing rate natin was 80, a bit too smooth for a wet runway. Alright, so manage lang konti daw yung ating flare later on next flight. Alright, guys, this ends our flight for this morning. It's already afternoon here in the Philippines. It's 12:17 Tuesday and let's try to fly later this afternoon. SkyMedic is now signing off. Thanks for watching and hope to see you later in the afternoon. Bye guys!
Salamat ninang sa